from Madrid. It's the first day here. We just got into the Airbnb and it's really nice, as you guys can see. Pretty nice windows here. And we're gonna head out and go explore some of this area right here. So let's go explore.
You gotta get the wine finished, the sweetest, best wine I've had. And we're just waiting for food, so we'll see how it is. I've heard good stuff about this place, and we'll see how it is.
Great. What it looks like. Insane, out of this world.
Okay, we just had some tapas in the Plaza del Angel at Tapa, and this area is just really beautiful. And you can see this beautiful building behind me. And life in Spain is just, it's great because it's very affordable and great. So we're gonna go try to find some tapas here. I'll keep you guys updated if we can find them because we're on the search. Good morning, it's day two in Madrid. We're heading to El Abasto, I think, or something like that. No, that's not what it's called. It's a market. We'll find it in a little, and I'll show you guys. Okay, first bite in Spain. Okay, so I've kind of abandoned the camera, but we're walking to the castle right now, and we just keep stopping everywhere because all the streets here are just insanely beautiful. So we're going to the castle. We'll see you there. Made it to the castle. It's beautiful. Behind me, the cathedral, and I just love the feeling of Europe and all these buildings with so much history. So. Oops, I almost died. All right, so we're in the back area of the castle. And there's this garden, it's really beautiful. So we're gonna check it out. Just made it to Toledo, which is a little medieval town about 30 minutes away from Madrid. So I'm gonna show you guys everything around here. Crazy beautiful, and just feels really nice here. Very medieval, like for real, you know. So we're just enjoying walking around, getting lost because we don't know where we're at, to be honest. So yeah. Hello back in Madrid. We just went to this place, Taberna de Mariano. Probably one of the best meals I've had in Spain. Price, value, quality, service, everything. So we're just walking around now after we got our fresh haircuts. And we're gonna go explore. Hello from La Plaza Los Cortes. We're gonna go get some coffee and we're gonna explore a different area of Madrid. Alright, we went to the shop and it was like a 20 out of 10 experience. Definitely recommended. Do you like it?
I love it. It was great.
We're gonna go look for a market. Alright, we're at the Mercado San Anton. We're gonna go ahead and try some food here and we'll let you guys know how it is. Market was a definite recommendation. I liked it better than the San Miguel market, to be honest. And now I'm on the search for sangria because I haven't had any since I arrived. So that's my next thing I'm looking for. All right, so after getting some empanadas, we're now heading over to the Parque El Oeste where we're gonna look for the Templo de Debod, which was acquired here by a donation from Egypt apparently. So we're gonna go check it out. Right, and I'm not sure if I ever mentioned, but I got my sangria and then I got a tinto de verano right after. They kind of taste the same, one with sparkling, one without. Tinto de verano sparkling. So if you want to try something different, I recommend it because they're kind of similar, to be honest, but they're both good. Change of plans. We came back to the Royal Palace. This time we are inside of the palace and we're going to explore a little bit and then we'll go to the temple, I think. So we'll see. All right, we made it to the temple. Show you guys some better shots. We just went to La Casa del Abuelo and we're heading home. And we're heading back home for a bit. Maybe we'll come back out, we're not sure yet, but at least we're gonna go rest our legs a little bit because we've been walking since 10 a.m. and it's 10 p.m. And it's our last day in Madrid. We're gonna go get breakfast and do all the things we want to do before. We are currently walking to find some cookies that some nuns make here in Madrid. It's called Las Carboneras. So we're gonna go find them. They sadly didn't have the cookies I wanted. I think you have to come really early in the morning because it's about noon, but you should go because it's a whole experience. You get to go inside of the monastery and everything, and it's pretty cool. And you get to go to this plaza, which is right behind me, which has beautiful views, which I will insert now. All right, so we're off of the Calle de San Nicolás. And these little streets off of the palace are just so beautiful because they're so small and it's so quaint and just beautiful. And it feels like you're living through history. We're in La Plaza Ramales, which again, just another beautiful plaza. One of like 5 billion, it feels like. There's just plazas everywhere that are all equally beautiful. We actually ended up getting tickets to the double-decker bus, which is a really good way to get to know a city. So we're heading that way, and I'll show you guys the view.
To record, but we had to run to the bus because nothing sad is coming, but we're off.
We're now at El Mercado de Cebada. Seems like a cool place, but everything's pretty much closed already on a Saturday at 3 p.m. so we're just exploring, but this is a cool place. Can't come to Madrid without coming to La Plaza Mayor. Really touristy but beautiful place with lots of buildings and restaurants. But we're gonna finish off with our shopping trip and getting souvenirs and everything because we are almost done here. All right, so some last takeaways about my trip to Madrid. I feel like it's one of those places that I wasn't really super interested in visiting until the opportunity came about, and I am in love. I think it's one of the best cities I've been to. Great culture, great opportunities, and if you're going with a dollar, it's also pretty affordable. Shopping is fantastic, so take some space for shopping and enjoy the tapas and aperitivos that come with your drinks because they are a way to make your trip a lot cheaper. And also just really take advantage of getting to see all the different locations in the city and outside. Toledo, Segovia, Barcelona are all just a trip away, and I definitely recommend hitting up this destination if you have the chance to do so. The neighborhood we stayed in was Barrio de las Letras, which I highly recommend. It's a very nice and safe neighborhood where authors used to live way back in the day. And I feel like it's a great place because it's very central, it's close to downtown, also to parks, restaurants, bars, and good metro stations. So a very, very nice and safe place to stay, in my opinion. Hope you guys like this video, and please subscribe if you haven't yet. Go ahead, like this video, leave me a comment, and I'll see you guys for the next video.